Hi, I am Dr. Mike Van Thielen. This video will elaborate on the five clean living principles. What are the five clean living principles? Number one, control your emotions and feelings. Number two, listen to the warning signs of your body. Number three, enough rest, sleep, and sunshine. Number four, active lifestyle, but no overstimulation and no overindulgences. And number five, natural and clean air, water, and food. The five clean living principles are explained in much detail in my book, Health for Life User Manual, and includes a step-by-step action plan that you can implement at your own pace. If you are serious in regaining control of your health and putting fibromyalgia into remission, purchase the book on Amazon or my website, mikevanthielen.com. In this video, we simply touch on the key points without getting into much detail. Controlling our emotions and feelings. Addressing our body's physical needs is a clear-cut task. Controlling stress and emotions is a more challenging task since it requires mental perseverance and input to achieve the proposed inner peace. Inner peace begins the moment you choose not to allow another person or event to control your emotions. And this task is very obtainable since humans have the power to choose their response. We need to acknowledge that our daily stresses and negative emotions have a detrimental effect on our health. So how do we control our emotions? Step number one, knowledge. First, we need to know our emotions. What emotions do we feel and how do they affect us? There are thousands of different ways one can feel, but human emotions have been classified, and the common ones are acceptance, anger, anticipation, disgust, fear, joy, sadness, and surprise. Jealousy, for example, is then a manifestation of fear. Fear that you're not as good as someone else. Fear of being abandoned because you're not perfect or you're not the best. You need to find out what kinds of situations cause which emotions and be able to tell the difference between anger and fear. Sometimes multiple emotions can bubble up at the same time, and it may be difficult to distinguish between these different emotions. My Health for Life action plan shows exactly how to put this into practice and succeed. Once you figure out what situations and thoughts elicit which emotions, we need to take ownership, which is step number two, taking ownership. Don't blame others for your emotions. Take ownership of your emotions. After all, you have the freedom to choose your response to any situation or stimulus. So if you decide to erupt in anger or frustration, or if you decide to worry or be fearful, that was your choice. You can't blame others for your own choices. Recognize when you try to blame other people for your emotions and don't let your mind get away with that trick. Taking full responsibility for your emotions will help you gain more control of them. And step number three, acquiring the skills to control your emotions. You need to acquire the skills to control your emotions. These skills include choosing your response, being proactive, changing your perspective, eliminating false core beliefs, recognizing thoughts and ideas that worsen negative emotion, helping others, and avoiding overstimulation and overindulgences. Besides mastering these skills to control your emotions, you need to consider making time for yourself. If you do not take care of yourself, you cannot take proper care of others or your loved ones. Make time for yourself and try yoga, meditation, or CBT, cognitive behavioral therapies, or find other ways to relax and reset your mind. Principle number two, listen to the warning signs of your body. Our body tells us exactly what to do in certain situations, if only we would listen. Examples: if the body needs rest, we will feel tired and sleepy, so we should rest. Instead, we tend to stay up and watch the end of our movie. if we aren't hungry, but the smell, our view, our thought of some yummy food crosses our senses, we tend to indulge even when we are not hungry. When we are sick and we don't have an appetite, our body tells us to refrain from food so it can fight the pathogen and doesn't need to waste energy on digestive efforts. Yet we are told to eat to keep up our strength. When we are in pain, our body tells us to stop doing whatever it is that causes that pain. Yet again, we usually ignore these signs. My Health for Life action plan teaches you to get back in tune with the warning signs of your body. Principle number 3, enough rest, sleep, and sunshine. During rest and sleep, our body renews, replenishes, and repairs. Lack of rest and sleep causes poor performance and drainage of vital energy, a low immune system, and sickness. Natural sunlight is vital to optimal health and performance. Light stimulates all biological processes and functions and has many nutritional functions also, including enabling the body to assimilate calcium, increasing red blood cell count, increasing oxygen carrying power, and improve healing, just to name a few. In short, sunlight stimulates circulation and oxygenation, which positively affects every single cell and every single function in our body. Man was made a nude animal, but clothes and spending most of our time indoors has a significant negative impact on our health. Our largest organ, the skin, is also affected and weakened by the lack of sunlight, especially in its elimination efforts of toxins. My Health for Life action plan shows you all the steps and actions you can take to improve sleep, rest, and exposure to sunlight. Principle number 4, active lifestyle. Exercise is vital for cell function and optimal health. But exercise doesn't necessarily mean one has to go to the gym or play organized sports. Walking, playing with the kids or the dog, taking dancing lessons, and any outdoor activity counts as exercise. Exercise means movement, and movement promotes circulation and oxygenation, just as sunlight does. Important to realize is that exercise expends energy and is destructive. Exercise needs to be compensated for with adequate rest and sleep, which is constructive by repairing tissue and replenishing the body with vital energy. Too much exercise or activity with inadequate rest or less than optimal nutrition results in energy depletion, impaired elimination, and toxemia. Athletes, for example, need to be aware that extra exercise produces extra free radicals, which needs to be neutralized for with extra antioxidants. Athletes often only focus on improving body physics, the motor, while neglecting quality and quantity of their vital energy, which is the driving force or the fuel of the body or their motor. Overstimulation such as excess input from radio, TV, smartphones, iPads, gaming, etc. drains vital energy and contributes to toxemia, as do overindulgences such as overeating, drinking, too much partying, etc. Principle number 5. Natural and clean air, water, and food. We need to turn our poor eating habits into some healthy ones. We need to replace man-made foods with natural wholesome fruits and vegetables. We need to replace sodas, coffee, milk, and juices with pure alkaline water. We need to expose ourselves to more clean air and do everything we can to avoid the inhalation of polluted air. We need to learn the basics of proper eating, including food combining practices and the alkaline food model. And we need to select the right supplements that can assist us in avoiding toxemia and obtaining optimal health. The saying, you are what you eat, is partially right, but we need to incorporate the other principles of clean living also. Also remember that health starts upon conception, so getting your children in the right habits early on is very important. However, it's never too late to regain control of your health. When you are alive and kicking, your body will continue to strive for perfect health no matter what. Living clean is a process, and our Health for Life action plan shows you step by step how to regain control of your health and achieve optimal health and happiness. Let's dive a little bit more into supplements. I often get asked if we really need supplements, and my answer always is a definite yes. Here is why. All commercial foods and drinks today are loaded with calories, chemicals, and toxins, but lack essential nutrients. Even if we would consume organic whole foods exclusively, we still need high-quality supplements, and here are the top three reasons. Number one, we don't get our fruits and vegetables out of our own garden anymore. We get them from the organic section at our supermarket, local health food stores, or the farmer's market. Therefore, there is a time that lapses between harvesting and consumption. And during this time, our healthy organic whole foods lose many live nutrients. For example, did you know that when you store asparagus for 1 week, 90% of the vitamin C is gone? Did you know that when you pick an apple from a tree, 50% of the enzymes are dead within 30 minutes? Reason number two. Most of our soils are depleted from essential minerals. After World War II, commercial farmers started to use NPK fertilizers, which contain only three minerals. Our body needs 60 to 70 minerals to function properly. And reason number three, we don't live in pristine areas anymore. We mostly live in cities and towns and are exposed to far more toxins than ever before. These toxins are everywhere. Exhaust fumes, the air, the environment, our homes, our water, and the list goes on. So in addition to a wholesome eating plan, high quality supplements become a nutritional insurance policy. Selecting the right insurance policy is of utmost importance. Now that we established that we do need supplements, the problem only starts, because the majority of supplements do not work. In my book, Health for Life User Manual, I outline the criteria to select the right supplements, including potency, safety, manufacturing practices, bioavailability, meaning how well the product is absorbed, completeness, dosage, and the best type of ingredients, meaning natural versus synthetic ingredients, among others. And only a small percentage of supplements pass these criteria. For more information on fibromyalgia and an easy to implement action plan to put fibromyalgia into remission, please visit my website, mikevanthielen.com.